Hello friends, now today we will study determination of Q point of FET. Yesterday we have studied Q point of BJT, now Q point of FET. I am drawing FET. BJT was having three terminals, emitter base collector. Similarly, FET have three terminals, drain, gate, source. In BJT, here it was base, here it was collector, and here it was emitter. So this is FET. This voltage, VGS, yesterday we have indicated here VBE in BJT. This voltage between gate and source, VGS, between drain and source, VDS, right? Current in this is ID. Yesterday we have indicated it as IC. In BJT we have indicated it as IC, now it is ID. So these four parameters you have to indicate. While determining Q point of FET, we have to write two equations. Equation number 1, equation number 2. And then you have to put equation number 2 in equation number 1 and you have to solve. Right? So equation number 1 is fixed, constant. I am writing that equation. This is fixed equation. So for while solving the numerical, the first step, you have to write this equation. Put down the given values in that equation. And equation 2, equation for VGS by applying KVL to gate source loop. Yesterday we have written equation for KVL base emitter loop. In BJT we have written equation for base emitter loop. Similarly, here you have to write equation for gate source loop. In place of base, there is gate. In place of emitter, there is source. Yesterday, we have written equation for this loop, base emitter. Now, we have to write equation for this loop, gate source. And that equation will be for VGS. Put equation 2 in equation 1 and solve. So, I am directly explaining this method by taking one numerical. Determine Q point. Determine Q point for the figure show. Yesterday I have told you that you have to convert the value in kilo. Now in FET, yesterday I have told that all the resistors must be in kilo-ohms in BJT. In FET it is little bit different. These two resistors must be in kilo-ohms. 1.8k, 300 ohms. I have divided 300 ohms by 1000, this 0.3. But these two resistors must be in same unit. These two are now in mega-ohms. Either in mega-ohms or in kilo-ohms. This important factor you have to keep in mind. That these two must be in kilo-ohms. These two must be in one unit only. Both must be in mega-ohms or both must be in kilo-ohms. Here both are in mega-ohms, so no need to convert. So additional data given is so this figure is given, this data is given, and we have to determine Q point. Yesterday in Q point we calculated collector current IC. So today we will calculate ID. Then we calculated VCE. Today we will calculate VDS. So Q coil means we have to calculate yesterday, here it was IC, here it was VCE. Now ID and VDS we have to calculate. So first step, I am writing this equation. For given numerical, you have to write this equation. IDS is equal to 8. IDS is equal to 8. Sorry. And BP equal to minus 6. So minus minus plus 6. Right? You have to put these two values. ID equal to 8, 1 plus VGS upon 6. Now, second equation for VGS by applying KVL to input load. Now I am indicating these values. Current into resistance will be voltage. VDS and VGS. Yesterday we have calculated V2 here. I am also calculating here again V2. Voltage divided this into this upon this plus this. Yesterday we have studied it. V2 is equal to 18 into 10 upon 110 plus 10. This will be 1.5. Right? Now second step, apply KVL to get source loop. This loop. Yesterday we have written this KVL. This V2 minus VGS plus 2 minus what? Current into resistance. Current into resistance is voltage. So we are going from plus 2 minus minus same, minus 2 plus same, plus 2 minus same, plus 2 minus, VGS is equal to V2 minus 0.3 ID. So VGS is equal to, I am putting this V2 here. Equation 1 is a fixed equation. Equation 2, by applying KVL to gate source loop, you have to obtain equation for VGS. So for that purpose, first I have calculated V2 by applying voltage divided rule, 18 into 10 upon 110 plus 10, that is 1.5. So we are going from minus 2 plus, so positive V2, plus 2 minus VGS, again plus 2 minus, current into resistance 0.3 into ID. So VGS will be equal to V2 minus, I have put this V2 here. Now put equation 2 in 1 and solve. Put equation 2 in 1 and solve. Right? So equation 1 is a quadratic equation. You will get two values. Out of these two, accept a smaller value as the answer. Solve. Out of two values, since equation 1 is a quadratic equation, you will get two answers. Out of two values, accept smaller value as ID. This is your first test. Right? Then yesterday here we calculated VCE by applying KVL to output loop. Now we have to calculate VDS by applying KVL to output loop. I am writing equation KVL to output loop. 18 plus 2 minus 1.8 ID plus 2 minus VDS plus 2 minus current into resistance minus 0.3 ID is equal to 0. So VDS is equal to 18 minus ID common in these two, ID is common. Put this ID here, that is second answer. So in FET you have to calculate Q point. Q point, that means you have to calculate ID and VDS. So how they are calculated? Indicate all the currents and voltages. Equation 1 is a constant equation fixed. This IDS is equal to 8 milliampere. Now second numerical. I have changed the data. This is 820 ohms. So I have converted it in kilo ohms by dividing 1000. 182k. This is 750 ohms. Divided by 1000 it will be 0.75k. This is 100k. This is 15k. Both are in kilo ohms. So no need to convert. IDS is again 8 milliampere, Vp minus 6 ohm. So equation number 1, IDS is 8 milliampere, Vp minus 6. Now I am calculating V2. 16 into 51 upon 100 plus 51. Came into this loop, V2 minus VGS minus 0.75 ID is equal to 0. V2 minus VGS minus 0.75 ID is equal to 0. So VGS is equal to V2 minus 0.75 ID and V2 is 5.4. This is equation number 2. Now we will put equation number 2 in equation number 1 here. In place of VGS, I will put this. So ID is equal to 8 right? So ID is equal to 8 1 plus 5.4 by 6, 0.9 minus 0.35 by 6. So this is 8 into 1.9 minus 0.125 ID square. ID is equal to 8 square, A minus B square. A minus B square. Now I multiply by 8. Eight multiply here. Then I will take this ID to this side. Right? So now minus B plus minus B square minus 4AC upon TA. This is B, this is A, this is C. So IDQ is equal to minus b minus minus plus plus minus b square. I have told you we have to accept smaller value. See, if I take plus here, it will be a higher value. So we have to neglect it. Out of two values, we have to accept only smaller value. So in place of plus minus, I am accepting minus, so that it will be a smaller value, right? So b square minus 4a into c upon 2a. Now I am solving this equation, right? So this VGS is put here, 5.4 by 6.9, 0.75 by 5. This is 1.9. A minus B square, this square minus 2 times this into this plus this square. Then I have multiplied it by 8. Then I have taken this I did to this side. So minus 3.8 and this 1. So minus 4.8 I did. And then I have written the formula. And now I will find out the answer. So IDQ is equal to 4.8 minus 2.9 upon. Here the equation is plus minus. I am accepting only minus because we want to select a smaller value of current. Seven point 4 6 milliamp. This is first answer. And second answer, KVL to this loop, VDSQ from this to this, this minus this plus this. See, in the above numerical, we have written this equation. So, VDSQ is equal to so, this is Q point. Q point is 7.46 milliampere and 4.27 volt. So, your answer is it will be very very easy for you in from exam point of view. Okay, this is about Q point of FET. Is that clear? Thank you.